In small plumbing water supply projects, that is, where there are just a few interior water networks, it is possible to have a single Autodesk REVIT's piping system to perform the hydraulics calculation with our Plumber add-in for REVIT MEP. We want to show you in this video the steps to carry out the riser pipe's outlet marking in these cases and, thus, internally within the program, separate them from the interior water distribution networks. Thus, it is possible, at the time of calculating and designing the water main risers, and, in general, the main distribution pipes, apply the considerations that the plumbing design methods establish for these components in the building's water distribution system. As we have anticipated in the previous video in this series of two, the option that we will explain here applies to networks of any type. But, our recommendation, in order to minimize errors and also the processing, calculation, and editing time, is to use it in systems that only have a pair of typical internal networks as well as water supply risers or distribution pipes. For this explanation, we will use this system with a single water riser pipe that serves three interior distribution networks on levels 1, 6, and 9, as you see here. Unlike the configuration explained in the previous video, the vertical distribution pipe is effectively connected to each interior network at these levels. With which you will see that everything is part of the same domestic cold water REVIT's piping system. That is why it will be necessary to indicate, to the plumber add-in, where finishes the riser pipe's water distribution function. This is done very simply using the available options in the settings panel that I show you here. The first of them, the set outlets thule, is the one that allows indeed to mark those pipes that, coming out from the water main riser, supply each interior network. In this project, there would be this pipe. And this one. Once selected, click the button and, if everything goes well, a message indicating how many pipes have been marked as outlets is shown. In other words, we are simply defining the entire route from the REVIT's piping system's supply point, located here. To each marked pipe. Note that we have not marked this one as an outlet because this pipe section does not behave like a main distribution pipe, since it only supplies one water network. Instead, the lower one, this riser pipe section, serves two. And the pipe sections from the supply point to this point supplies the three water networks in this project. It is also available the Delete Outlets tool. This one allows you to eliminate, or rather, to remove the pipe's outlet marking inside the add-in. When you click it, you will see, here in the status bar, a message asking you to select the corresponding pipes. I'm going to select both because you notice that the command remains active until you click Finish here. When finished, I click it, and an informational message appears. Finally, the See Outlets button allows the automatic selection of those pipes in the REVIT project that you have previously marked as outlets. I'm going to mark the two pipes again to show you. Now, when you click this button, you will see they become selected. So you could, for example, in addition to knowing which ones are marked, Use the delete command to restore the Revit piping system's original condition. This option, the one of not having pipes marked, would allow you to carry out the calculation and design as if no different criteria exist for main distribution pipes. So you have two variants to perform the water distribution system design with our add-in for Revit. Thanks for your attention.